Our plan was it to take the staysail and the jib down for the winter while the boat is on the hard. The main and mizzen sail could stay up because they are furled up in the masts. At first we managed to take the staysail down in this quite windy day, before we had to lift the anchor and sail up the Formosa River. We needed to fold the sails in a proper way to get them back in their sail bags. Next step was to hoist the dinghy and store it properly on deck and secure it with lines against the gusts. Sudden, it's time. We need to get the anchor up and go up the river. We had to wait for the right tide. The tidal difference is about 2 to 2.40 meters in this area, and now it's going to high tide, so it's the right time to go up the river. The shipyard is on a place where there is no water, really almost nothing at low tide. We stretched about 70 meters of chain to secure the ship in the tidal streams and the heavy Atlantic gusts at that time of October. Sometimes we have been kind of unlucky and caught with our anchor garbage, like fish pots, fish nets, old ropes, whatever, and that turns around the anchor and keeps it away from digging into the deep mud. We used our electric winches extensively to get our anchor up, check for garbage and relaunch it. So that was really, really helpful to have these powerful electric winches, because the anchor chain and anchor, it's really backbreaking heavy. It's a buoyed waterway that leads up the Formosa River to the waterfront of Faro. There is another smaller anchorage, barely big enough, but we will wait there for the pilot boat from the shipyard. In the meantime, we sail up the river, and while we do this, we got time to prepare our lines, because we need to fix the boat on the dock when we are up there. When we arrived at the anchorage, the actual problem is not the size of the anchorage. It's big enough for one ship or maybe five, depending on the size of the ships. But there is already several ships anchored, and it's only at low tide a small pond of water what is left. Thank you.
Wow, it's pretty narrow here. Around this, all this boat, very, very narrow. And these boats are also swinging around this. Oh yeah, it's pretty tricky, huh? It needs really an escort to go down, to go inside. Yeah, and there's always a sandbank beside. It's just we are following the canal and following the guy exactly. We have to be careful that, Oli, because we have to follow exactly him.
Yeah,
there's always boys, mooring boys and everything here. It's pretty narrow. And then, yeah. It's pretty adventurous, the shipyard here, huh?
On land. This shipyard is on land. It's only flooded by tide, this area.
Oh yeah, look at that. And this, all of this. So, yeah. If there is no escort, not possible to go through to this area here. Oh yeah, this is pretty narrow, but it's all good. Yeah, that's all. Kanano. Not yet, Oli. It's not the time to care for it right now. We need to go through. And where's the shipyard now? That is a shipyard, huh? Yeah. That's the shipyard over there. And look at this. It's just land here. You can step there. We are now following, they are escorting us, this man here. the shipyard.
Thank you.
The fences are all up. Olha o que é que ela está a dizer ali do outro lado.
Nesta chapa dá-se grande. É aqui, nesta chapa dá-se grande. Estás a ver?
Uh-oh. I guess we have so much scratch on our boat when we launch this in because it's too just so narrow. Our boat is too big. Unfortunately. So that one out there?
Yeah, and the back stays.
And also the back stays?
Yes, I saw it. So the back problem is the antenna wire connected inside.
Yeah! So Oliver has to take the back stays there so that they can pull that up. Yeah. And I'm going to go inside to get my laptop down.
Thank you.
because so they are putting the strap now.
So we had to squeeze Vela Nautica into the crane bay. The shipyard provided some carpets because it was no more possible to put fenders in between. And we had less than 2 inch on both sides space to squeeze her in, and it was very tight.
So we have to switch off fridge and freezer, off and
fresh water pump,
fresh water pump, fridge and freezer,
fridge freezer,
autopilot,
yeah, everything, tech.
Everything off.
Electric. Okay. To clean the downside, yeah, of the keel.
So Vela Nautica is looking good.
the pressure was.
But why it's more down here like this now? It's not properly
balanced.
Look at this.
The crane is too small.
Oh, why is that? I'm so scared.
We go lunch now. And then?
Well, now. No, I don't want pressure wash.
No?
No. But I think that's not necessary. I won't take the hook on. We need to do this now while they are in lunch. We can wash around with the sponge. And they will pressure wash only the downside of the keel.
Yeah.
But we are allowed to
Uppsala. Stand. Uppsala. I guess it's too down in the front only.
What too down? No, no, that's normal. It's always cracks and this plastic here cracks. When there's a plastic.
Okay.
Yeah, right.
Better view.
Yeah. Okay.
So I will just wash the water line with a hose and a sponge.
Yeah.
I need an old pants. I will use.
So that's all for today's episode, guys. If you like this video, please hit the like button and
subscribe. Your subscription helps us to produce more videos like this.
And don't forget to hit the notification bell beside the subscription button
to get notified when we upload a new video.
So, cheers guys,
cheers.
And waves to all of you. Bye, see you in our next episode.
Da-da-da.
What time is it? It's 6 p.m. so it's good for a sundowner. Cheers.
6 p.m. sundowner? So
yeah.
It's allowed since 12 a.m.
So I guess that's all. We got it.
Yeah.